Hey guys, yet another project idea. I know it's never ending. I'm a bit out of control, possibly. Out of my vinyl stashes here, let me pull up some of this. Here we go. Some of this tint here. You know, I was working on that emblem issue I talked about earlier today. These emblems they've kind of worn out their specialty with me. I'm kind of tired of them. They're too plain. As like, no depth is what I don't like. I like the 3D stuff. And at first, I was thinking about a gloss black wrap. Period. Nothing on it. Just a gloss black. Everything. And I thought, that could be a little bit plain, but it could be interesting. I mean, if that's what I want, you know, to hide. I mean, just not to advertise the car brand, you know, make people that don't know guess a little bit. And then I thought maybe I can take a bone stock emblem and throw my 20% tint on it and maybe not see through it, but maybe it as a way to like an alternate darker emblem style, but maybe retain some of that depth if you can even see through it. If you can't, well, it's almost the same. It's just going to be a nice dark emblem. But this one looks a little too cheap for me now. I mean, I loved it for a long time. It was part of my look. But I needed a little change on that. And now is the perfect time because I'm working on my new emblem style. Oh, I did a nice paint job on two of the rears today. Pretty nice paint job right there. That's 3-4 coats, except for that freaking tape where I tape it down. But that's on the bottom, so I'm seriously not worrying about that for the rear. It's on the bottom, right where the tape is. But the other one's even cherrier. This was like my Subi Speed crappy plastic dip, and I shaved it all down, cleaned it all up, and did a proper paint job on it. And this one is pretty much flawless. So these are for the rears. Now, of course, I don't have a rear disc, so I'm waiting for that to arrive. It's going to take a whole week, so my rear is going to be emblemless for a whole week. But up here, I do have two front discs to play with for my next design I was just talking about. So I don't know, I could tint that, could look cool, because it would pretty much look black. I mean, it might be just the same as having a gloss black if you can't even see through it, you know? But I could try that first, and if I don't like that too much, I go straight gloss black. Just really stealth out the car a bit more. It's kind of exciting for me, something new to try for a little while. Kind of late tonight, Saturday night. And it was a long day out in the sun, wedding parties, stuff like that, and I just like can't really sleep right now. I'm too amped out, just loving my car too much, so I'm gonna keep working on it here. And you'll probably already just saw a video I released a few minutes ago, and I'm working on this one tonight also. I gotta probably save this one for tomorrow. I don't want to, you know, spill my whole seed in one night. Oh guys, happy Father's Day to all of you. You're probably watching this on Sunday, on Father's Day. Hopefully I'm doing something with my kids right now since I made this last night. Hopefully I'm out not working on my car today. Might be driving it, having fun taking the kids somewhere, but not working on it tomorrow. Tomorrow's for my kids. I guess it should be for me, but for me, the happiness is my kids, so it all ties together. So anyway, let's get to work on this. All right, so like I start all these videos, I do the alcohol, and I sanded off a little spot there. Just, I'm never going to use this finish, so I didn't care about sanding it a little bit and get the edges pretty much like that. Not touching the actual areas that are going to be on the emblem. Looks like I have a crease here, but I may just be able to avoid it if I place this just right. Okay. Now this stuff, you remember, is so easy to use. Just peel it off. Work out all your dots, and you can stretch it. And remember, this has a top coat so you can peel. I mean, this is a few seconds, really. Especially since it's off the car, off the emblem, that makes it super easy. Luckily, I have three of these front discs to play with. That's pretty much it. I do want to work on getting some of those little air bubbles out. So, without touching the under part, I just work them forward. Ah, that one's giving me trouble right there. Okay, push really hard. Push the center, then I can work out like that. You know, as long as the center doesn't have bubbles, the rest I can figure out. But when you got one right in the center, that's always a pain in the ass. There's a bubble. There's one right there above my thumb. Lift. Don't put your finger where it's going to touch. Roll out. Two bubbles above my thumb. Roll that out. Start in the center. Work your way out. Then I don't see any more real bubbles. A couple tiny things there I can probably do away with. I mean, you can just, it's not hurting anything to peel it up. Just keep going until you're satisfied. Pretty much can't get better than that. I got out almost every single bubble out of this thing. Pretty much that's what we're looking at. Kind of a cool darkened theme. It's not bad. Let me trim it up a bit. Again, the other option is this premium 3M 1080 plain black gloss with no see-through capability if I just really want to black it out and go totally stealth. That's a second option I have. This is pretty easy here. I'm just going to use the side of the blade as my cutting line. Go very carefully around the corners. Of course, this will tuck into the frame, so it's not that critical that you get the cutting just right, because it'll probably be hidden under that frame when you're done. And I might even find out that I need to leave a little lip there. As I push it from the back, it'll suck that lip in and hold it even better. I'll have to see how this fits in the frame first and if this wasn't the right way to cut it. Better watch my fingers there with this razor. I mean, even when I use new razor blades, still, this stuff is so hard to cut, all of it, my vinyls, my tints, with a brand new blade, sometimes you just won't even cut it. You need like some serious art tools to be able to cut this stuff. There we go, that's a 20% tint, stock emblem. And after I clean most of the fingerprints off, pretty cool, interesting look. Peeling off that emblem this time. A lot of times you can really screw it up, and at least I didn't crack it or anything. Then I'm just going to push out the disc very carefully. See, putting pressure on all this frame is what'll bung up the paint. You got to be super gentle. Release that carefully. And just don't put really hard fingerprints on these beautiful frames. I can clean that up with alcohol. It'll look pretty much good as new. So, let's see. Flip it over. Okay, I forgot that this does come in from the front, so that tint there could be a problem with it being visible. Yeah, I'm going to have to do something else on that because the edges will show through. I'm going to have to wrap it around somehow. That's one option there. Now, this is not the one you saw 1 second ago. I put that one aside because that's like my best one in case I want to use it again. And see, this is my second bet. Not as good a one because you have some white leak. This was a different brand and you had white leak on the edge. So that's why I'd rather peel this one and wreck this one than peel the one you just saw, which is my best one. Just so I don't have to like redo it later. Now I'm gonna try some black gloss on this. Just see how the hell it looks. Now, from everything I've seen, this stuff does not have a peelable top layer. That's only tint that has that. So here, I mean, you just gotta clean your top layer when you're done, when all your fingerprints, because you're kind of, you can't help it. You're gonna get stuff on this. This is looks like it's even easier to apply than that tint, though. I just don't like to get my fingers too into the mess there. But see, this stretches real nice over those edges. Oh yeah, I can cut it back here. See, at the bottom of this ridge, then this ridge will sink into the frame and it'll hide it. I should have done that with the tint. So there you go. See, I learn, every time I do it, I learn some more. So I'm pulling this over that ridge so I can cut it below the ridge, and then any bubbles here don't matter. See that? And I would have liked a little more vinyl so I could have more stretching ability, but this will work. Maybe it'll come out perfect, but I could use more vinyl and have a better pull and feel on the install there. But this is actually working pretty freaking good. Ooh, there's a big bubble, damn it. So you peel it back, work the bubble out, work a little bubble out right there, and it's gone, it's cherry. Okay. So yeah, you keep got, sometimes a bubble will appear after you've gone over, made a site perfect, a bubble will pop up. With all this pulling and stuff, you're like shifting the air, so you always want to double check afterwards, see if you created a bubble in your custom work. This is pulling really nice over here. I'm really pleased with this, the way it's working. This is easier than the tint that we just did, but if I wrap the tint around the edge again, around this border, I think it'll actually work a lot better too. I should have done that. Oh well. I got 10 feet, 15 feet of that tint that I used earlier, so I can just do this tint as many times as I need. Now, as we talked about, right there, see that? Keep your vinyl on the edge. Oh yeah. Guys, this is so fun. This is just a really fun way for me to spend a Saturday night. I mean, I know y'all love your cars, but I don't know if y'all love your cars as much as I love my car. I mean, do you spend every day of your life working on your car, thinking about your car? I mean, my kids are very important, my family's important, but for my hobby, I'm talking about, my work is important, but for my hobby, my personal hobby, this is what it is for me. And I've been doing this since like 1986, maybe. 87, maybe. I don't know. Whenever I turned 15, 16, got my learner's permit at 15 and a half. My parents lent me the money for my first car. I don't even remember. In one of those years, 76 Toyota Corolla with 168,000 miles. Stick shift. And I used that for a while. All right. There we go. I mean, let me clean the vinyl. The vinyl could be really weird. I mean, I know people will say, dude, why would you want a pure black emblem? I don't know. Why not, man? Why not? Why the hell? Why don't you want to try and be different? Just for the hell of it. Sure. There. That did clean up nice. So even though it has a lot of fingerprints, it came out pretty nice. There are a couple. I mean, honestly, I kind of like the black one more. I don't know. Maybe I will stop this video now and post it before I reinstall all this crap and change my mind and your opinions sway me. So I'll go ahead and stop the video now, let you see what's going on.